Good morning, Mr. Ambassador.
Good morning.
And spouse. So welcome to Merdeka Palace in Jakarta. So we have several questions to ask for you.
Sure.
The first one is light question. So we assume that you already stayed in Indonesia for a couple of days or weeks perhaps. So maybe you could tell us what was your first impression about Indonesia?
Yes. Selamat pagi dan salam sejahtera dari Ecuador untuk rakyat Indonesia. Well, thank you very much. To me, it's a pleasure to be the new ambassador of Ecuador to Indonesia, to this great country, and to work to improve the relationship between both countries, Ecuador and Indonesia. We have 41 years of a very prosperous relationship in the diplomatic field. We have been working in several issues in the bilateral field and also in the multilateral field. In the bilateral field, we have carried on some MOAs, memorandums of understanding, and some other instruments, international instruments, to give more content to the bilateral relations. No? For instance, we have been working in science and technology, agriculture, trade, the culture that is very important because that is good for the relationship between the people of both countries. And just to mention a few. No? In the multilateral field, we have been working also in the international organizations like United Nations, no? And some other organizations. And we have been approaching positions. For instance, we recognize the leadership, the important leadership of Indonesia in some initiatives like the case of Myanmar, for instance, regarding the diplomacy. No? I think it's very important to mention also the membership of Indonesia to the Security Council in United Nations. And Ecuador is going to try to get a position also as a member of the Security Council in 2022. So we have several things that we are sharing between Ecuador and Indonesia. Yeah.
All right. Very comprehensive answer, sir. Thank you very much. Enjoy the
Thank you very
the
much.
Eh?
Thank you. Thank you.
Good morning, Her Excellency.
Selamat
so welcome
pagi.
To Merdeka Palace in Jakarta. So there are one questions for you. So COVID-19 are still with us. So how do you see this pandemic could not be an obstacle for Indonesia and Australia to strengthening their relationships in the future?
I think that both of us have been impacted by COVID-19, and I think together we're stronger. We've got lots to do in health security, but I think economic recovery is going to be really important for both of us, and I'm really committed to really driving the economic relationship between Australia and Indonesia so that the prosperity of both of our countries can be improved as we recover from COVID-19.
So as the predecessor of Mr. Gary Quinlan, so how do you continue his best effort before?
Oh, Gary did a fantastic job here. He really built the relationship up. But for me, I come as myself. I'm the first woman, Australian woman ambassador to Indonesia. And also for me, it's seperti pulang kampung. 40 tahun yang lalu, saya mengikuti program pertukaran pelajar di Indonesia. Saya tinggal dengan keluarga Indonesia selama setahun dan saya sekolah di sini, SMA kelas 2.
So you pretty much know about Indonesia. So maybe you can tell us about what is your favorite food and where is your place, favorite place to go in Indonesia?
So I love all of Indonesia and I love Indonesian food. But as a 16-year-old living in Jakarta, I do love somai and I like the kaki lima somai in the Menteng area.
All right, thank you very much,
Your
Excellency.
Much.
Enjoy Bye-bye. The occasion. Okay, good morning, Mr. Ambassador. Welcome to Merdeka Palace in Jakarta. So the first question, so could you tell us about how do you see about the relationships between Indonesia and Ireland in the future? How can you enhance the cooperation between two countries?
Well, first, could I say, saya senang sekali berada di Indonesia. Saya merasa terhormat ditunjuk sebagai Duta Besar Irlandia untuk Indonesia. Saya sudah belajar sedikit bahasa Indonesia dan saya mau belajar berbicara lebih baik. So I am, as I said, delighted and honored to be here. I want to increase the knowledge between our two countries, the knowledge of each other. We are two countries far away from each other, yet I think we have much in common, two island nations. I think the important thing is to increase people-to-people links between Ireland and Indonesia. And in my time here, I want to encourage more Indonesian people to visit Ireland, and in particular to study in Ireland, because I think it is only when people live in each other's countries and get to know each other that we can have true friendly relations between states.
Since you already speak Bahasa Indonesia, so I'm assume that
Hanya sedikit, Hanya sedikit.
So I assume you already know about Indonesia. So could you tell us what your favorite food in Indonesia and where your favorite place to go in Indonesia?
Well, unfortunately, because of the current situation, I have not been able to travel outside of Jakarta. And I hope that as soon as restrictions allow, that I will be able to see more of this beautiful country. I've had many friends who have visited here, and they have told me about the variety and beauty of the many different parts of this country. I know that Jakarta itself is a beautiful city and a very pleasant one to live in, with very friendly people, but I know the same can be said of many other parts of Indonesia. And I look forward to traveling around and indeed to trying the many different foods of every part of Indonesia.
All right, thank you very much, sir. Enjoy the occasion this morning. Thank you.
Terima kasih. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum, Pak Duta Besar Mauritania. Selamat pagi, selamat datang di Istana Merdeka Jakarta. Pertanyaan yang ingin saya sampaikan adalah sebagai Duta Besar yang baru dari Mauritania, apa harapan Anda terhadap hubungan bilateral antara Indonesia dan Mauritania di masa yang akan datang?
Assalamualaikum sahadat safir, marhaban bikum fil qasr riasi, sabah al khair. Suali al wahid huwa madha ta'malu wa madha tatawakku minal ilaqat al-thunaiyah baina Indonesia wa Mauritania bisifatikum ka as-safir al-jadid.
Selamat pagi. Atasharafu liyum bi taqdimi waraq a'timadi ila fakhamat rais al-jumhuriyya Sayyid Joko Widodo بصفتي سفيرا للجمهورية الإسلامية الموريتانية وأملي كبير في أن تتعزز العلاقات بين البلدين في كافة المجالات. موريتانيا مثل ما تعرفون بلد يقع في شمال غرب أفريقيا، له موقع استراتيجي متميز، إطلالة كبيرة على المحيط الأطلسي، ويتميز بوفرة الثروات الطبيعية المتنوعة من النفط للغاز للمعادن الذهب والنحاس والحديد، ويغذي السوق غرب إفريقيا. وأتوقع أن موريتانيا ستكون بلدا واعدا لجلب الاستثمارات الأندلسية، ونأمل أن تكون هناك شراكة استراتيجية بين البلدين في كافة المجالات، خاصة في المجال الثقافي، التبادل الثقافي في مجال التبادل التجاري وفي مجال الاستثمارات في كافة المجالات. ولي أمل كبير أن تتعزز العلاقات إلى الأحسن إن شاء الله، وشكرا.
Merupakan suatu kehormatan besar bagi saya pada hari ini dapat diterima untuk menyerahkan surat kredensial kepada Presiden Joko Widodo. Indonesia adalah sebuah negara besar yang mempunyai tempat penting dan kami anggap sebagai negara strategis di kawasan. Dan sebagai Duta Besar Mauritania yang baru untuk Indonesia, saya akan berupaya keras untuk memajukan kerjasama bilateral antara Indonesia dengan Mauritania di segala bidang. Salah satunya terutama di bidang investasi dan perdagangan, di mana kedua negara mempunyai potensi yang besar. Saya bisa sebutkan salah satu di antaranya adalah dalam hal minyak bumi, emas, dan juga pertambangan. Selain itu, saya juga ingin dengan kedatangan saya di sini, kita akan memperbanyak dan meningkatkan dan mengintensifkan kegiatan kerjasama antara kedua negara, sekali lagi terutama di bidang investasi dan perdagangan. Terima kasih.
Terima kasih, Pak. Selamat datang sekali lagi.
Syukran jazilan, sahadat safir.
Bapak Presiden yang kami hormati, perkenankanlah kami hadapkan 4 duta besar luar biasa dan berkuasa penuh dari negara-negara sahabat untuk menyerahkan surat-surat kepercayaan. Yang pertama, kami hadapkan kepada Bapak Presiden Yang Mulia Tuan Santiago Javier Chavez Pareja untuk menyerahkan surat-surat kepercayaan sebagai Duta Besar Luar Biasa dan Berkuasa Penuh Republik Ekuador untuk Republik Indonesia. Kami hadapkan kepada Bapak Presiden Yang Mulia Nyonya Nikki Penelope Williams untuk menyerahkan surat-surat kepercayaan sebagai Duta Besar Luar Biasa dan Berkuasa Penuh Australia untuk Republik Indonesia. Kami hadapkan kepada Bapak Presiden Yang Mulia Tuan Padre Francis untuk menyerahkan surat-surat kepercayaan sebagai Duta Besar Luar Biasa dan Berkuasa Penuh Republik Irlandia untuk Republik Indonesia. Yang terakhir kami hadapkan kepada Bapak Presiden Yang Mulia Tuan Hussein Sidi Abdullah untuk menyerahkan surat-surat kepercayaan sebagai Duta Besar Luar Biasa dan Berkuasa Penuh Republik Islam Mauritania untuk Republik Indonesia.